This is the second video and it's a continuation of the first video wherein we have talked about the interchanging of distance. And we have seen how if the distance are interchanging, then we can avoid the formula and with the logical approach, we can solve it quickly without making any equation. So let's continue here. Now, in this question, it says a person goes 45 kilometer partly by train and partly by car. So some part by train and some part by car. Further, it says if he goes 24 kilometer by train and the remaining by car. So 24 by train and remaining by car. So I can say I am traveling certain distance by train and certain part by car. So 24 by train, so remaining 45 minus 24. And 45 minus 24 is 21 by car. In 2 hours and 30 minutes. So the total time duration is 2 hours and 30 minutes. I can write it down. Or it's not necessary. If he goes 18 kilometer by train and remaining by car. So 18 kilometer by train and the remaining by car. So 18 kilometer and I can say 45 minus 18, 27 by car. I am taking 30 minutes more. So find the speed of car and the speed of train. So let's see here. So you can see here there is a gap of 6, 24 minus 6, 18. And 27 minus 6, that is 21. So I can divide the distances in couple of parts here. Just see how. So total distance is 44. The first part I'll say 18 kilometer. So let me write it down, 18 kilometer. 18 plus 6 is 24 kilometer. So 6 kilometer. And then I can say that is 21 kilometer. So the total distance is 18 plus 6, 24. 24 plus 21, that will be 45 kilometer. So I can say I can divide the entire distance in 3 parts here. Alright. Divide the entire distance in 3 parts. 18, 6 and 21 here. Okay. So let me say this is 18 kilometer. Then this is 6 kilometer. And then last one is nothing but that is going to be 21 kilometer. Alright. Okay, now first case, what does it say? 18 kilometer by train, 24 kilometer by train. So I can write down train, 18, 6 kilometer train. So 18 plus 6 is 24 and the last part by car and the total time taken by me is nothing but 2 hours and 30 minutes. So that is 2 hours and 30 minutes. Okay, now if he goes 18 kilometer by train and the rest of them by car. So train and rest remaining all 27 by car. So car and car. The time increased by 30 minutes here. So I can say that is 2 hours and 30 minutes plus 30 minutes. That will be equal to how much? 3 hours. So there is a change of half an hour or 30 minutes. Now we need to understand why the time has been increased or decreased by 30 minutes. What is the reason behind that? So let's see here. In the first slot, if you look at here, in the first slot, train and train. So, of course, there is no change in the time. Last slot, car and car, there is no change. But for the middle 6 kilometer, the moment I shift from train to car, okay, there is an increase of 30 minutes. Remember, there is an increase of 30 minutes. Or I can say if I'm moving from car to train, there is a decrease, 3 minus 30 is 2 hours and 30 minutes. But this is happening for what? For a stretch of 6 kilometer only. The middle part is of 6 kilometer. Now, if I travel the entire distance by car, let's see what is going to happen if I travel the entire distance by car. So last part by car, okay, there is no change. Car to car, there is no change. But for the first part, the moment I move from train to car, there is going to be some change. My time will further increase. How much? Now for a 6 kilometer, just see it here, for a 6 kilometer stretch, the time increased by 30 minutes. So for 18 kilometer, 6 into 3, so 6 into 3 is 18, so total increase in time is 30 into 3. 30 into 3, there has to be increase of 90 minutes. So if I travel the entire distance by car, the time taken by me will be 3 hours plus 90 minutes. So 3 hours plus 90 minutes, 90 minutes is 1.5 hours. So I can say 4.5 hours. So which means if I travel the entire distance by car, the time taken will be 4.5 hours. So what is the speed of car? So I can say speed of car, total distance, which is 45 upon total time 4.5. So 45 upon 4.5, that is equal to 10 hours. I hope that it is clear. Similarly, we can find out for the train. Just see how. Okay. Now, train to train, no change. Train to train, no change. But the moment I shift from car to train for these 21 kilometers, the time is going to decrease further. How much? For a stretch of 6 kilometers, there is a change of 30. So for a stretch of 21 kilometers, 6 kilometers decrease in 30 minutes. So 21 kilometers means how much? 6 into 3.5 is 21, 6 threes are 18, and 6 into 0.5 is plus 3. So 18 plus 3 is 21. So 3.5 times. So the time will further decrease 30 into 3.5. And what is 30 into 3.5? 30 into 3.5 is 105 minutes. So in 2 hours and 30 minutes, subtract 105 minutes. So 105 minutes is what? 1.5 hours, 90 plus 15. So if I subtract 90 minutes, so I left out with 1 hour and then further 15 minutes. So it will be comes out to be 45 minutes. So if I am traveling the entire 45 kilometer by train, I am going to take only 45 minutes, which is 3 by 4 hours. So what is the speed of train? So now we can calculate it. The speed of train, it is equal to how much? 45 upon 3 by 4, which will be comes out to be 60 kilometer per hour. Okay, 60 kilometer per hour. And the speed of train, okay, it is not 10 hour, it has to be 10 kilometer per hour. Okay, be careful regarding the unit, 10 kilometer per hour. So you can see that here, I have not tried to make any complicated equation by taking the variable x or y. By simple logic, we find out what is the time taken, and we already the distance is given, so we can find out the speed. Let's take one more example based on this. Before looking at the solution, try to solve it on your own. It says Nitin covers a distance of 22 km by traveling 2 hours on bus and the remaining distance for 3 hours on a car. So he travels 2 hours by bus and 3 hours by car, and the total distance covered, it is how much? 22 kilometers. Had he traveled 3 hours on bus and 2 hours on car. Now remember, here the timing is changed, not the distance, but the concept is same. Interchanging of time happens. 2 hours on bus, 3 hours on car. Now 3 hours on bus and 2 hours on car. He would have covered 1 kilometer more. Means 23 kilometer now, 22 plus 1, 23. So find the speed of bus and speed of car. Okay, let's see. Total 5 hours. So I'll say, there are 5 stretch of 1 hour. Or it's not necessary to write down, but depends upon you. So I can say 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour, and 1 hour, and 1 hour. So there are 5 stretch of 1 hour. So Nitin covers a distance of 22 kilometer, 2 hours on bus. So first hour, if I travels by bus, second hour also by bus, and the remaining 3 hours for car. The total distance which I can cover is 22 kilometer. Okay. Had he traveled 3 hours on bus. Okay. 3 hours on bus. So if I travel 3 hours by bus, first hour by bus, second hour by bus, third hour by bus, and the remaining 2 hours by car, the total distance will be 23 kilometer. So you can see there is a change of 1 kilometer here. So why there is a change? Now for the first hour bus to bus, no change. Second hour bus to bus, no change. Last hour car to car, no change. Second last hour car to car, no change. So this change is happening because of this middle hour car to bus. Okay, and there is a change of 1 kilometer. So if I move from car to bus, the distance is increased by 1 kilometer, or if I move from bus to car for 1 hour, the distance will further increase by 1 kilometer. So let's see. I can say car and car. This part car, just keep it. Car to bus, okay. Bus, keep it bus. Bus to bus. Bus to bus, no change. But the moment I move from car to bus, distance will increase by 1 kilometer. Okay, there is an increase of 1 kilometer. Again, for the last 1 hour, instead of car, if I travel by bus, it will further increase by 1 kilometer. So total is 25 kilometer. So if I travel the entire distance by bus, in 5 hours, I can travel 25 kilometer. So what is the speed of bus? So I can say speed of bus is nothing, but that is 25 by 5, which is equal to 5 kilometer per hour. With a similar logic, we can solve it for speed of car. Let's see how. Okay, car to car, no change. Car to car, no change. Car to car, again no change. But the moment I shift from bus to car, distance will further decrease by 1 kilometer. And here also bus to car, it will decrease by 1 kilometer. Okay, so total distance will decrease by 2 kilometer. So if I travel the entire distance by car, I can travel how many kilometers? 20 kilometer in 5 hours. Because for the two of these stretches, I converted from bus to car for the first 2 hours. So what is the speed of car? So I can say that speed of car, it is equal to 20 by 5. And 20 by 5 is equal to 4. So 4 kilometer per hour. So now I hope that you understood the concept of interchanging of distance or interchanging of time and how we can tackle this question without using any equations or any complicated formula. So in the next video, we'll see the application of ratio and proportion. So you can now move to the next video, which will be uploaded soon.